very good afternoon. I'm Jaya Saranya.
Fahana Mudin.
Pavitra Singare.
So, the title of our project is Sonic Panels. And the objectives are to create sonic panels using sawdust and rice husk. The second one is to test the panels for noise reduction coefficient. The third one is analyze the data and the best panels based on the noise reduction coefficient.
So the design process is to start searching for material, mixing process, compaction complete, and compaction extended for 4 days. And after that, drying process, testing and analysis, and the end of the remaking the panel.
Okay, lastly, analysis, data and discussion. So first of all, the first graph is about graph of 100% 80% 60% rice husk for shaped panels. And then the second graph for flat surface. Third graph is for 100% 80% 60% sawdust shaped surface. And this one for flat sawdust surface. So altogether we have compared and we have calculated the noise reduction coefficient. So based on the results, we have concluded that 60% sawdust panels are best to be used as the noise reduction panels. And as the conclusion, yeah, 60% sawdust panels is best to be used. And we are recommending the future research to be used to increase the surface area by putting more polystyrene balls or by differing the by changing the total surface area, by adding more shapes to it, and maybe they can change the binders with Arabic gum for to increase the fire resistance. So that's all from us. Thank you.
My matrix number is 01DKA14F2010.
My name is Vishwaran, and my matrix number is 01DKA14F2008.
So the title of our pioneer project is Concrete Waste as Recycled Aggregate in Cost Mixture. So the problem statement, our problem statement is that we have two problems. First is space. So concrete waste has multiplied largely in the past few years. So there is a high demand of land to dump all of this concrete waste. So the second problem is resources. So road pavement uses a lot of natural aggregates that we harvest from the mountain. So we might be running out of this source in the future. So our intent is to use recycled aggregates replacing virgin aggregates in wearing cosmetics. The objective of our project is to design a wearing cosmetics using a different proportion. So we have three proportions. The first is 100, 50-50 and 100% virgin aggregates. Our second objective is to measure the stability and optimum bitumen content. Stability is the strength of the specimen. And also optimal bitumen content relates to the suitability of the specimen and also the most cost effective way to design a mix. The third is to identify the proposed design meets the standard specification set by public work department, is to know whether our design meets the standard that has been set by PWD. So,
I'll tell you my methodology. So first of all, we start our project by producing recycled aggregates. So these recycled aggregates are produced from pilings which were cut down during piling process. So the excess piles which were cut down during the piling process. So we washed it, freed it from the debris such as string phosphate, cured it and dried it to get the recycled aggregates. So then the recycled aggregates was used to prepare master specimens. So we did three different proportions to prepare using 100% recycled aggregate, and second proportion is 50-50 using 50% recycled aggregate and another 50% virgin aggregates. And for the third proportion is using 100% virgin aggregates. So from the results, we can say that for stability, the 100% recycled aggregate did not meet the JKR standards. For flow, there was certain bitumen contents which met the JKR standards. And for bulk specific gravity, virgin aggregates recorded the highest bulk specific gravity, and the recycled aggregate recorded the lowest bulk specific gravity. And for white spin bitumen, all three proportions were in the range of the JKR requirement. And for the white spin mix, there was also bitumen contents for all three proportions where they meet the JKR standards.
So for the conclusion, it is proven that our profitability proportion it matches the standard that has been set by JKR. So I think that is the most suitable design that we have in our project.
So we also would like to recommend usage of recycled content below 50% in the very cost mix. That's all from us. Thank you.
The project is about research, so I would like to introduce ourselves first. My name is Kevin Ho and my partner.
All the recent.
So our title is Sustainable Development and Management on Working Pathway and Bicycle Parking in Polytechnic Unggul Omak. So our first objective is to determine the non-motorized facility within the area of Polytechnic Unggul Omak. And our second objective is to provide a 3D AutoCAD drawing that will suggest the improvement for the facility that previously identified. So next I will pass to my partner.
Okay, next I'll talk about the introduction. So as you can see, the definition you made, sustainable development, that means the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. Sustainable development is a widely increased all over the world to protect and enhance the environment. So surely the efforts has to be taken in various types of countries, even overseas, that make all of the world to increase the sustainability of development patterns. So as you can see, this is the diffraction of walking pathway. So there are various types of diffraction, the width, the sidewalk cracks, dislocates, and some of the pathway they never provide with the awning and concrete trail. The concrete trail was used to connect the bridge, so it cannot supposed to be concrete trail, so it should be a nice slope as to be provided to connect the bridge. And some of the walking pathway they never provide the slope. As you can see, the slope is over here, so some of the walking pathway currently they never provide the slope, ending slope. And the data would be, we have made a sensor study to analyze how many motorized and how many non-motorized they enter inside the Polytechnic Unggul Omak. And this is our methodology. We have planned, we have analysis, and we have obtained the data, and we have sketched, and we have designed the AutoCADs, and also we propose. So next I pass to my group mate.
So the facility we focus in non-motorized facility are walking pathway and also the bicycle parking slot. So we have three suggestions for the walking pathway. The first is we replace the aluminium awning to zinc. Although the zinc material is more expensive than the aluminium, but it in terms of heat conductivity and also the degree of rust, the zinc is performed better than the aluminium. And second, we suggest to add the slopes in degree of 20 degree, so it also according to the standard. So it not only in the entrance and also exit of the pathway, it also include in the middle of the pathway. It also we also call it flat. So the suggestion for the walking pathway is gutter. As you can see, there are many sizes for roof gutter, so we take this as the roof gutter size. So we will add the complete system of cutter for air flow for walking pathway. So for bicycle parking place, we suggest to add the ring instead of currently yellow bar steel. So we can replace with the bicycle ring with the size of this diameter and the height. So we suggest also to add the bicycle parking place. And we suggest to add the awning for the parking place because some of the parking place without the awning. So as I will pass to Paul.
So as a conclusion based on the design that my groupmate has explained, so the result should be we have to promote and we have to create a new idea for Polytechnic Unggul Omak to enhancing eco-friendly environment. So maybe this design might helpful to the Polytechnic management. And as a conclusion, the management has to be aware and notice to improvise the walking pathway and also implementing the non-motorized facilities in several parts, and it also also encourage the usage of disabled pedestrians. And by and at last, by the design that we propose, it can reduce the motorized vehicles and implement, as I said, eco-friendly environment. So that's all from us. So finally, we would like to thank our Dr. Haji Razu Anafi to support us and our co-supervisor respectively, because they gave us idea and some of the helpful facts until we can able to finish our project itself. So thank you.
This is my partner, Prasanna Sri Ravi,
and we are here to explain about our project, main portable cleaning kit for maintenance work. So the main objective of this portable cleaning kit is to produce an easy way and user-friendly product in maintenance works to clean wall, window and drain. And the second objective is to assist the workers in conducting routine of maintenance works. Next, my partner will be explaining about the PCK product.
Before that, this is our poster, as you can see here, and this is the PCK product. It's attached with three tanks, 10-liter tanks with a flexible hose here, and then outlet pipe, pressure gauge. It's a recycled container and wood plank. Behind there is a switch, and inside there is a diaphragm pump with motor battery. Okay, most of the things are recycled things.
And look at the result and discussion. As you can see in this table, in this panel here, time taken, we have taken the time and the volume of water and pressure, and we also observe the cleanliness. And here's the feedback from the workers. And
they are the workers of Polytechnic Nkoma. According to the graph, 5 male workers said that easy to use this PCK, while 4 female workers said that it's easy to use. Except if one of them said moderate.
So in a conclusion, this PCK is adequate with the requirement for cleaning process.
And we achieve our aim for green technology by using the recycled things.
Thank you.
I'm Krisha Nigam from Vikram Gandhi. So today we are going to present on Sherek Chair that we innovated. So our problem statement will be existing high cost of product. Second will be the existing few caregivers to care the handicaps. Existing handicaps that could not be able to carry out their own activity. So our objective is to investigate the problem faced by handicapped people in handicapped children welfare home. And second will be to design an efficient multi-purpose chair to the handicapped people due to facilities need for handicaps. And the last objective will be to test the consumer satisfaction towards Sherek Chair product. Okay, we have test our product using some of the parameters. Let's look at it. Okay, first parameter will be ergonomic design. Second, multifunction of chair, hygienic level of chair. Next is comfortability of chair. Next is chair design with lightweight. Sixth is maintenance. And then the safety. At the last, we test the satisfaction. How we test was like, we distribute 10 questionnaires to the caretakers at our target places, which is in welfare children home in Ipoh. So through that, we collected some of the data. So now my partner will explain about the innovation.
Okay. So like we look at the functions of Sherek Chair. This is the dining table, which will keep the food and drinks. And this is the cushions for recliner, seat, and to keep the legs. This is the armrest, and of course, this one's for the holder to keep things. And we use the wheel to move. This is the lockable, and this one is non-lockable. Okay, and of course, this all is made up with the PVC pipe. And we have different types of connectors. We have 5 types of connectors, which is the 4-way, 2-way, 3-ways, and also 90 degrees plus T connectors. So in Malaysia, we have 2 types of connectors, which is T connectors and 90 degree connectors. And the rest, we did the PVC welding. So this is our innovation of Sherek Chair.
result is all the caretakers, around 85%, are satisfied with our product. So that's all from us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Taufik Bekerul Zaman, 01 DKA Bangunan F2006. My supervisor is Puan Julia Habib Tiabur Rahman. My final project is Frame Time Method. What is Frame Time Method? The introduction, Frame Time Method is the study to improve the work for changing time by reduce the time taken for changing the time. The aim of this study is to design frame and make it become new installation method. This means the study and innovation the time will install without using cement. This method will use frame as tie binder with the floor. The problem statement is, for change the existing installed tile, will need much work to change its position. Number two, must have the skill to install the tile. That will take time, a lot of work to do, change tile. Therefore, this frame time method will solve that problem. The objective frame time method is to propose a new innovation of tile installation method and to reduce time taken to change the existing tile to the new one for the future. This is my methodology, choosing project title, brand and brainstorming, design the product, machinery, material selection, construct the method, product, model analysis and result. This is the result and the discussion. Result, test has been done with my friend's style method by taking time taken and compare with all method with frame time method. The graph is time taken versus length frame. The test was done by 3 times. This is the graph when using all method and this is the graph by using frame time method. All method is tile installation using mortar and new method is tile installation using frame. The graph is the blue graph is skill level while the red graph is unskill level. Discussion, frame time method has achieved the objective by referring to the graph. The time taken was reduced by using frame time method compared to the old method. Although the objective has been achieved, they have some disadvantage by using frame time method and have more to improve. The limitation of this frame method, when using this frame time method, we must use the same size of tile. We cannot use the another size. That is the limitation. And my suggestion, we can use any other material that can more durability.
Let me introduce myself. My name is Puti Salafisa binti Muhammad Sukipi. This is my partner, Siti Nurani binti Muhammad Safa. We have been supervised by Puan Nur Hasli binti Hassan. Let me introduce our portable air handlers. According to Ministry of Education, mobile air condominium are apartment for students to be as their hotel center. We then provide all necessary facilities to ensure the comfort of students, including co-hanging the decor. Fresh kediamans for the diploma have been chosen as our survey locations of this study. Our objective is to identify the problems that faced by hostel residents using existing cloth hanger. Second is to fulfill the requirements of cloth hanger by hostel residents. Lastly is to design a new student needs cloth hanger. I will pass to Nani.
Okay, let me talk about the data collection from the data analysis. We use 3 parameters. First is a learning test, questionnaire and interview session. For the learning test, we have taken 5 different of which that of clothes. So here the levels. From here you can see in 10 kg for the portable clothes hanger have inclination for 10 degrees. But for the conventional clothes hanger doesn't have any inclination but have slack off at 4 kg which is 5 degrees. And the slack off will increase until more than 15 kg to 50 degrees. Okay, here is the conventional clothes hanger that have slack off and you can see here the slab of the provides. And then we continue with the questionnaire. And the questionnaire, we ask how which clothes hanger that they would prefer. Most of the respondents choose portable clothes hanger rather than conventional clothes hanger, which is 88.4% of them choose that. Okay, we move to the interview session. For the interview session, we did after the user used our product and the respondent gave a good feedback and there was satisfaction with our product. And as a conclusion, most of the residents will choose our product compared with the conventional clothes hanger. And because it is fulfill the requirement needs and we achieve all the objective in this product. Okay, thank you.
Brush for extension and tube. So brush material we use for brush polyester, for extension aluminium and tube rubber. So objective. Our objective is to upgrade an existing parallel to be more flexible and to design a parallel that can save time when that can save time of painting at the specific area. Okay, now I'll continue the methodology, the finding and analysis. For finding analysis, we take the used by the interview protocol where we ask the respondent, we take 5 respondents and ask them about our product after their testing, what they feel after they use our product. And another one, you use the time taker, take the time taker for the respondent, paint the wall, which is the area of the wall is 5 times 10 feet. So the width is 10 respondent, we take the time taken based on their skill and based on the time they paint the wall for the 5 times 10 feet. And what can I conclude from the analysis is during the testing, the respondent is quite excited to use our product and the most of them agree with our product, which is easier the painter to use it where they do not need to go numerous times. And conclusion is the our objective is achieved and the result say that we can all the respondents agree with this innovative product is Estee Pendolin. So that's all from us. Thank you.
Okay, the title of the project is a zinc concrete system. Okay, the objective first to reuse rain water in the poly system, and second to upgrade the tank by using the poly water tank to store the rainwater. And last objective is to measure the temperature of the installing the cooling system. Okay, first the methodology effort. When our first part is we'll pump the rainwater into the top of zinc, and then the hole is made by spray that water in zinc, and then the water will flow from the top into the pipe collector, and then water from a pipe collector will enter the poly dirty water tank.
Now, from the pipe collector, before the water enters the water tank, it has to pass through our rain shower head. So, with the rain shower head, it will flow down in so the whole surface area as it showers down. And then there's a fan here, so the fan will cool the hot water that comes down from the rain shower head. So, when the water is cooler, it will go to the tank. And this is our data that was taken. So we took the data for 3 days. We started at 11 in the morning and finished at 3 evening. And as you can see, the data that our system works and you just pull down the system. So that's all from us. Thank you.
All right.
Topic of my project is eco-friendly roof. Introduction is, according to Fodern, global temperature has increased around 0.5 degrees Celsius by every year. So by creating eco-friendly roof, it can prevent the heat transfer to the interior, so can reduce the CFC gas which is produced by air conditioning, we can reduce the usage of air conditioning. So my objective is about to build eco-friendly roof using zinc and styrofoam. Then my second objective is to compare the temperature and humidity by mixing with the styrofoam and without the styrofoam. Actually, this is the result. So top one is the graph for the result. So top one is the zinc roof without styrofoam. The temperature is much higher, and the bottom part is the zinc roof with styrofoam, which may have low temperature. Actually, the temperature is not much difference. It's around 2 to 5 degrees Celsius only, but it actually helps to reduce the temperature. So the conclusion, actually the objective is achieved by using the styrofoam can reduce the temperature. So.